Dear friends, welcome to Think BRICS. On November 6 and 7, a special event, important event, happened here in Iran. It is called deBlock Conference that will definitely leave its footprint in the future of international finance system and payment system in particular. I am glad to introduce my guest today, Mr. Pooria Asteraky. Welcome to Think BRICS.
Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure for me to stay here, to be here, to talk to you, to talk to your team. You did a very great job. First of all, congratulations.
Appreciate that. Thanks for coming to the break.
So let's start with the very beginning. What was on the grounds why you decided to organize this event, to organize deBlock? What was on the grounds?
There were a few local, national, and international causes. And we just put all the causes together, mix it up, and came out with this new formula that we can have scientific, academic conference. It can be international. And next to the conference, we can have a networking event. We can have also an international event. So we mix it up, the technology part and academia, the business side and the government side. And the common elements of all these three, we just created, developed deBlock based on the common elements of these three. So what we did, we have a conference, which is an academic conference, a paper competition, where we receive papers from all over the world, more than 100 papers, and they compete to get 12 Ethereum bonus, which we handed to the winners today. And the other part was that so many medias and diplomats and businesses were invited to deBlock. We had this chance to get a good networking in some BRICS countries such as Russia, UAE, and now deBlock is multidimensional event. Mm-hmm. And I'm very glad about that.
Thank you. But what was the main message of this event?
The main message is increasing crypto adoption, reducing government restrictions, not only Iran government, mm-hmm. all government restrictions to currency applications and adoption. And also, we see a future for blockchain in BRICS. The slogan of the conference is the future of BRICS through blockchain.
Why it is important, in your opinion? Why blockchain is important?
Because BRICS is looking for de-dollarization of international trade. And we believe that to handle cross-border transaction optimally, the best solutions are coming out of blockchain. You have to build on blockchain. You have to use cryptos, create new tokens, and all these things helping BRICS come up with the technology and a tool set of financial of monetary solutions to compete with SWIFT and other traditional banking system and tradify and traditional
Western-oriented.
So indigenous solutions most probably are built on blockchain because it's a new technology, a high-end technology. That's why no one goes back and creates something with technology of 50 years back, like SWIFT.
Big event, great number of guests, speakers. What was the difficulty, the main difficulty in organizing all this for you?
The main difficulty, first of all, we were supposed to have this event on 15 and 16 of June 2025, last June. And as your audience certainly know, attack on Iran occurred by the Zionist regime. So that was a difficulty. But aside the war, the main difficulty was to orchestrate governments, academia, and businesses because they have a lot of conflict of interest. And to convince businesses to finance an academic event which has no business application or marketing use for them, and to convince governments to support this and participate in this, while different parts of governments may not be very friendly with crypto in general, not only in Iran, in other countries. Same. To orchestrate this coordination between three different bodies in many countries, that was the main challenge. However, I enjoyed this challenge, but and I guess in general, I guess especially in Iran and in some other countries, BRICS countries such as Brazil, such as India, the participation of governments was very encouraging. Mm-hmm. We never faced a closed door. So, and it was amazing. It was a thing that I wouldn't thought. So I would think that would be many barriers, many no's. But hopefully from businesses, I get very good response. From governments, I got very good response. And I've had many yes. I'm happy with that.
I'm sure that you hope to have obstacles, but your work brought you to this result. One question I would like to ask, what do you hope people will learn from this event and take away from them from this event?
Maybe people learn to compromise of some of their interests and to live and work and develop in a harmonious. Because I've seen that businesses compromise to help science. Scientists compromise because it's a multidisciplinary subject,
yes,
the blockchain technology. And I know that it's not easy for law researcher or economic researcher to shift and do research on blockchain. And because it's some areas is technical and it's different than what he used to and what he learned already in universities or in colleges. So it's a challenging thing to do research about blockchain and crypto in all the areas. The legal aspects of blockchain and crypto is very difficult to be understood by a software engineer or developer. So, they had their own challenges. Business had their own interests and challenges, and governments have their own interests. But everybody compromised to do this, and we all came together and did it. And I think that's a very good lesson. The other thing is that we gave a very good award to about 20 people, distinguished article and selected article, top article. And I guess it is very encouraging for the next year and next years. And our participation and article submissions and entries will increase dramatically, hopefully from other countries. For example, we didn't have entry from India last year. We didn't have entry from Russia, as far as I remember. We did have entry from USA, Malaysia, some other countries, but we didn't have from Russia and India. And I hope that the amount of bonus and the quality of execution of deBlock and how we performed it in participation with many international journalists and diplomats and business people, I hope that our participation next year will increase.
So you want to say that deBlock is open not only for BRICS countries, but for entire world?
Of course. Today we had a dialogue with on the stage with First Secretary of Japan Embassy. We discussed about technology, especially fintech and blockchain technology in Japan. And she shared some very amazing and interesting insights that how Japanese are advanced in blockchain. And they are so humble because they don't advertise it.
Yes.
They're so humble. They're just,
they could share their knowledge.
Yeah. They don't advertise it, they don't show it off, but they are using it, and that was amazing what Japan is doing. So it's international in a friendly manner, in a good will, and we hope that participation and interest from all countries.
And one speaker from the United States.
Yeah, we had one speaker from United States who kindly participated in morning. We were trying to arrange visa for him to invite him to Iran. Unfortunately, the time was too short and the procedure for visa was not completed. So we asked him to participate online and he did so kindly. So we see from US, from Russia, from China, India, Japan, Brazil, Malaysia, Cuba. So from many countries we had participants, and that's very encouraging for us.
We may say that blockchain has no borders.
Yeah.
Everyone may participate.
Yes, trustless. Trust.
Well, the first edition is over. So one more time, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
From your conversation, there are some hints about the future. So what's next?
Next, of course, we do have plans for next year. Now we start to prepare gradually for the academic part.
Okay.
And we have a policy-making team, a policy-making committee. This policy-making committee will be organized again for this year, I mean 2026. And then after that, we announce our call for paper. That's usually our first step. And after call for paper, we try to finance the next year conference. And we are also discussing with Trescon from UAE, discussing for deBlock to be organized in Dubai. So we have deBlock Dubai. or deBlock Riyadh in Saudi Arabia. We are discussing it in the conference, and we signed MOU for that. And maybe we organize in 2026. It's a very good possibility that we organize such event in Dubai also.
I wish you good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And thank you very much for your interview, for your time, because you was extremely busy, busy. So just a few minutes for me. I appreciate that. Thanks a lot.
I am admiring and appreciating Think BRICS. Think BRICS was first international media that supported deBlock when deBlock was only an idea. In that stage, usually media don't trust the organizer because organizer hasn't done anything yet, hasn't shown anything yet. Nothing tangible is there. But Think BRICS trusted us, supported us in all steps of the way. You announced our call for paper, you announced the conference. I think 5-6 different announcements came from Think BRICS, and I appreciate that. I hope your whole team could join us here in Tehran. But unfortunately, there was some issues, and I'm thanking God that you could make it and come here.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you for the interview. Subscribe to Think BRICS. It was a pleasure for me to stay here. It was a pleasure to visit Tehran for me for the first time. And I expect it was the first, but not the last time. And we will visit the capital city of Iran more frequently. Thank you for the organization. It was great.
Thank you.